Hi everyone, welcome to Bodyworks Prime. Today we're going over the origin, insertion and action of the transversus abdominis muscle.
Pictured here, we can see the transversus abdominis muscle by itself. As the muscle fibers approach the midline, they form an aponeurosis, which is a flat tendinous-like material. This aponeurosis then inserts into the linea alba, which is a white line which runs down the middle here. The linea alba is comprised of the aponeurosis and the three abdominal muscles which make up the rectus sheath. So the three muscles which form the rectus sheath are the transversus abdominis, the external oblique, and the internal oblique. The last two of our five abdominal muscles are the rectus abdominis and the pyramidalis. These two muscles sit inside the rectus sheath, much like a sword is held in a sheath when it's not in use. So the rectus sheath wraps around the rectus abdominis and the pyramidalis, holding them both in place. So our first point of origin, you can see marked out here in red, is going to be the iliac crest. And you can see, based on this origin, how the transversus abdominis wraps around the side of the body here. So we can see our next point of origin here, which is the inguinal ligament. Now the inguinal ligament connects onto the anterior superior iliac spine, and then it comes down here and connects onto the pubic tubercle. And you can see I've marked out here in red the portion of it where the transversus abdominis connects onto. So that's the superior 3/4 of the inguinal ligament. So moving around to the posterior of the body here, you can see this section which I've highlighted in green, and this section is the thoracolumbar fascia, which is essentially a diamond-shaped area of connective tissue, and this connective tissue is another origin of our transversus abdominis muscle. And if we're to go back to a skeletal view again, we can see the 11th and the 12th rib, and you can see I've marked out in red the points which the transversus abdominis is connecting to on them. But it's not just that 11th and 12th rib around the posterior of the body that it's connecting to, because the transversus abdominis wraps around the body. So we've gone back to an anterior view here, and you can see this red origin I've marked out, and that's on the costal cartilages of the 7th to the 10th rib, and then it goes all the way around to the posterior of the body onto that 11th and 12th rib as well. So it's originating from the costal cartilages of the 7th to 12th ribs. So that was quite a lot of origins to remember. Thankfully, there's not quite so many insertions. The first one's nice and easy. I've got it highlighted here in blue, and that's the linea alba. And you remember, the linea alba is just comprised of the aponeurosis of the transverse abdominis, internal oblique, and the external oblique. So now we can see our last point of insertion, and that's highlighted here in blue, and that begins on the pubic crest here, and then it works its way across to the pectineal line. You might also hear the pectineal line referred to as the pectin pubis. But it's not just the transversus abdominis muscle that's inserting here, it's also the internal oblique muscle as well, and that's because both of them connect together to form the conjoint tendon, which is a sheath of connective tissue formed by the lower part of the common aponeurosis of these two muscles.
So let's have a look at the actions next. Now the transversus abdominis muscle is wrapping around the core here, so as it contracts, that's going to compress the contents of the abdomen, and it's also going to increase intra-abdominal pressure. So I'll show you an example here. I've brought along a weightlifting belt. Now the transversus abdominis muscle has often been referred to as your body's weightlifting belt because it serves a similar purpose. So with a weightlifting belt, if you're going to lift a heavy weight at the gym, perhaps a squat or a deadlift or something like that, you might use one of these, wrap it around your waist here, tighten it up, and then you'd breathe in nice and deep and press out against it. And that pressing out against it is going to increase your intra-abdominal pressure, and it's going to increase the stability around your core. That's going to translate into increased strength and power on your lifts. So the transversus abdominis muscle is going to serve a similar purpose, because it's wrapping around here. As it tenses, you can kind of push out against it and brace against it. Now, it's not just the transversus abdominis muscle which can do this. Obviously, your other muscles around the core as well can tense, and they can help provide a similar role. But the primary action of the transversus abdominis muscle is to perform that role. So if you've enjoyed the video or you found it helpful, you know which buttons to press. Press that like button, press that subscribe, leave a comment, let me know what you thought of the video. Thanks again for watching, everyone. See you all next time.